لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. All praises to Allah, Lord of the worlds, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His final messenger Muhammad, upon His family, His companions, and all those who follow in His way.
إخواني كثير من الزوجات.
My brothers, verily many of the wives.
يشتكين من سرعة غضب الزوج.
They complain about how quickly their husbands become angry.
ولأتفه الأسباب.
And for the minutest of reasons.
وكثير منهن.
And many of them.
لا يعرفن كيف يتصرفن مع الزوج لحظة الغضب.
And they don't know how to deal with their husbands when they become angry.
فمنهن لا تفكر في عاقبة تصرفها مع زوجها لحظة الغضب.
So some of them they do not think about the outcomes of this of when he becomes angry.
إذ يقتصر تعاملها في هذه اللحظة.
For her dealing with him in the, at this moment of angry of when he becomes angry.
يقتصر على التحدي.
It is something where she does to put down a deadline or to put down a command.
أو عناد الزوج.
Or to make him even more angrier.
أو مجابهة الغضب بالغضب.
Or she repels this anger by becoming angry herself.
أو بسلاطة اللسان.
Or she speaks too much.
أو تعمد المخالفة.
Or she intentionally disobeys him.
فتنتهي الحياة الزوجية بالطلاق.
So then this married life or this marriage ends in divorce.
من أجل ماذا؟ من أجل لحظة غضب.
All because of this small instance of anger.
ثم بعد ذلك يذهبان ويسألان هل هذا الغضب يقع أم لا؟ هل هذا الطلاق يقع أم لا يقع؟
And then they go and they look for a fatwa whether this divorce took place or not, whether it was right or wrong.
بينما يمكنها تخطي لحظة الغضب.
But rather it is possible for her when he becomes angry.
من بنوع من المداراة.
By using some form of intelligence
التي تحول الزوج الغاضب
which will turn her angry husband
إلى محب عاشق
to one who is beloved.
فما هي الطرق لتحويل الزوج من حالة الغضب إلى حب وعشق؟
So what are the ways in which she can turn him from angry to beloved?
الطريقة الأولى.
The first way.
لا تجادل الزوج لحظة الغضب.
Do not argue with him when he becomes angry.
وإنما عليك بالصمت.
But rather you should remain quiet.
صمت القوارير. صمت النساء.
The quietness and the silence of the women.
عبد الرحمن كان يزور أمه.
عبد الرحمن would visit his mother.
كبقية إخوته.
Like the rest of his brothers.
ولكنه يتميز عنهم.
But he would be special.
بصفة خاصة.
With one characteristic.
أنه إذا ما غضبت والدته.
For when his mother would become angry.
أو تكلمت معه بشدة.
Or when she would say something which was harsh.
صمت.
He would remain quiet.
تقول كلام لا يسره.
It is something which she would say something which was not appropriate.
لكنه سكت.
But he would not say anything.
ثم انسل من المجلس وخرج.
And then he would leave.
ثم يزورها في وقت آخر. كأن شيء لم يكن.
And then he would visit her at another time as if nothing had ever happened between them.
بينما باقي الإخوة.
Whereas the rest of the of his brothers.
إذا كلمتهم أمهم.
When their mother would say something.
بكلام شديد.
Something harsh.
ردوا عليها.
They would return this and they would repel this.
وتعاملوا معه بشدة.
And they would also say something harsh in return.
تقول إحدى بناتها.
One of her daughters said.
سمعت أمي في يوم من الأيام.
I heard my mother say one day.
تقول في مجلس.
She said in a gathering.
لم يكن أخي عبد الرحمن جالسا فيه.
In which my brother Abdul Rahman was not present.
فقالت.
She said.
اللهم إني راضية عن عبد الرحمن.
Oh Allah, I am pleased with my son Abdul Rahman.
اللهم أرضى عنه.
So Allah be pleased with her.
اللهم أرضى عنه.
So Allah be pleased with him.
ثلاثا.
She said it three times.
تقول أخته.
So his sister said.
فقلت في نفسي.
I said to myself.
ليتني مكان أخي في هذه الدعوة المباركة.
Were it not that I was in his place while she is making this dua.
تكمل الأخت فتقول.
And his sister continues and says.
أخي عبد الرحمن.
My brother عبد الرحمن.
لا يخطر في ذهنه شيء ما.
Nothing comes into his mind.
إلا وسارعت أمي في تلبية حاجته.
Except that my mother will hasten in fulfilling his needs.
حتى لو لم يتلفظ هو بطلب هذا الأمر.
Even if he does not request anything.
وإنما لو فهمت من بعيد.
Even if she understands indirectly.
حققت له مطالبه.
She will hasten to do this.
إيجابيات كثيرة.
There are many things.
تحققها الزوجة.
That a wife can do.
بالتزامها الصمت.
If she remains silent.
لحظة غضب الزوج.
When her husband becomes angry.
غضب الزوج ليس نهاية العالم.
When a husband becomes angry, it is not the end of the world.
وليس هو دخول نار جهنم والعياذ بالله.
And it is not like someone entering the fire.
الكافر عندما أخذ يجادل ربه.
The disbeliever when he will argue with his Lord.
في يوم قد غضب الله عز وجل غضبا.
On the day when Allah will become angry.
لم يغضب قبله مثله.
He will not have become angry like this ever before.
ولن يغضب بعده مثله.
And he will never become this angry again.
لم يتحول غضب الرب إلى رضا.
This anger will not turn into pleasure.
بسبب جداله.
Due to this argumentation which will take place.
يقول الكافر.
The disbeliever will say.
يوم القيامة مجادلا.
On the day of judgment, whilst arguing and debating.
يا ربي.
Oh my Lord.
ألم تجرني من الظلم؟ ألم تجرني تمنعني ألم تمنع الظلم من الوقوع علي؟
Did you not stop oppression from befalling me?
فيقول الله عز وجل بلى.
So Allah will say yes.
فيقول إني لا أرضى.
Then he will say, but I am not pleased.
على نفسي إلا شاهدا من نفسي.
That I will not be pleased except with a witness from myself.
فيختم الله عز وجل على فيه.
So Allah Azza wa Jal will close his mouth.
فيقول لأركانه انطقي.
And then he will say to his limbs, speak.
فتنطق أركانه بعمله.
So his limbs will speak with regards to his actions.
قد فعل وقد عصى.
That he said that he did such and such and he disobeyed you.
فيقول عبد لأعضائه.
So then the servant will say to his own limbs.
بعدن لكن وسحقا.
How evil you are.
فعن كن كنت أناضل وأجادل.
It was because of you that I was debating.
لكن انظروا إلى المؤمن.
But rather look at the situation of the believer.
عندما لم يجادل.
When he does not argue.
وإنما صمت.
But rather he remains silent.
يدنيه الله عز وجل.
Allah عز وجل brings him closer.
ويستره يوم القيامة.
And then he will be pleased with him on the day of judgment.
فيقول له الله عز وجل.
And Allah will say to him.
أتعرف ذنب كذا؟
Do you know the sin you committed?
أتعرف ذنب كذا ألم تقع فيه؟
Did you not commit such and such a sin?
فقل نعم.
He will say yes, oh my Lord.
حتى إذا قرره بكل ذنوبه.
Until he agrees and he attests to all of his sins.
يرى العبد بأنه قد هلك.
He will think that he is destroyed.
فيقول له الله عز وجل.
So Allah will say to him.
قد سترتها عليك في الدنيا.
I concealed these sins from you in the world.
وأنا أغفرها لك اليوم.
And I will forgive them for you today.
فيعطى كتاب حسناته. فيعطى كتاب حسناته.
And then he will be given his book of good deeds.
هذا حديث رواه البخاري ومسلم.
And this is in Bukhari and Muslim.
بالتزام الصمت وعدم الجدال.
When one remains silent and does not argue.
تغير غضب الرب إلى رضا.
This anger of Allah Azza wa Jal turns into pleasure.
بينما بالجدال.
And in the other case, when someone argues,
زاد الغاضب غضبا على ذاك الكافر.
The one who is angry, meaning Allah, increases in his anger.
أيتها الزوجة.
O wife.
كوني كالزجاجة النقية.
Be like a clear glass.
إذا سقطت عليها أشعة الشمس.
If the sun's rays fall onto it.
الغاضبة الحارة هذه الأشعة.
Which are very strong in their heat.
فإنها تنفذ من خلال هذه الزجاجة.
Then it goes through this glass.
ولا تنعكس هذه الأشعة.
And it does not repel these rays.
بل كوني كالقوارير أي كالقارورة.
But rather be like a vessel.
التي إذا سقطت عليها أشعة الشمس.
Which if the sun's rays fall onto it.
ظهر جمال هذه القارورة.
The beauty of this vessel becomes apparent.
وظهر انحناءاتها وكذلك تثني هذه القارورة.
And the beauty and the form and the shape of this vessel becomes apparent.
تقول إحدى الزوجات.
One of the wives said.
عندما تزوجت.
When I got married.
ظننت أني سأكون أسعد امرأة في العالم.
I thought that I would become the most happiest woman in the world.
لما تمتعت به من الجمال.
Because I was very beautiful.
وكنت أظن.
And I used to think.
بأني سأكون خاتما في بأن زوجي سيكون خاتما في يدي.
That I thought that my husband would be like a ring in my finger.
فكنت أتجادل معه في كل قضية.
So I used to argue with him in every single matter.
ولا أحصل في النهاية على مرادي.
And I would never ever reach something which would benefit
وإذا
me.
وإذا لامني في يوم ما وغضب علي.
And if he would become angry and blame me one day.
رددت عليه بعشرا.
I would repel this with saying 10 things about him.
أصبحت حياتنا كالجحيم.
Our life was like a fire.
كدنا ننفصل عدة مرات.
And we would separate many times.
ولاحظت.
And I found out
بأنني إذا لم أتجادل معه
that if I did not argue with him
أحصل على مرادي
I would get what I wanted.
هكذا كانت النتيجة.
This is what the result would be.
فقمت ألتزم الصمت.
So then I began to remain quiet.
فبقيت حياتنا واستمرت على الحياة الزوجية.
So then we were happy together.
لا تجادل الزوج لحظة انفعاله.
So do not debate him when he is angry.
إذا كان غاضبا سيزداد غضبا بالجدال.
If he is already angry, when you argue with him, he will only increase in his anger.
وإن لم يكن غاضبا سيتولد فيه الغضب.
And if he is not angry, then he will only become angry.
دعيه يفرغ كل ما عنده.
So let him remain quiet and let him say what he wishes.
فإنه سيصبح بعد ذلك صفحة بيضاء نقية.
And then after he has finished, then it will become like a new page.
وسيراجع نفسه في حال صمتك.
And then he will think about what he has said whilst you are silent.
ولا أقصد في نفس المجلس.
And he may not be in that same gathering.
ولكنه إذا خرج بعد ذلك.
But maybe if he leaves that gathering.
فإنه سيحاول تصحيح موقفه.
And then he will try to rectify his position.
ويحاول أن يراضيك بطريقة ما.
And he will try to please you in some way.
كما مرت علينا قصة مصعب بن عمير.
Like the story of Mus'ab ibn Umair which you mentioned.
مع أسيد بن حضير.
With Usayd ibn Hudayr.
كيف غضب عليه أسيد؟
How Usayd was angry with him.
ما رد عليه وصمت.
But he didn't say anything. He didn't reply and he remained quiet.
عرض عليه الإسلام فأسلم أسيد.
And then he told him about Islam and he accepted.
أتى سعد بن معاذ.
And then سعد بن معاذ came.
غاضبا واشتد على مصعب.
And then he was also angry and he said something against مصعب.
صمت مصعب.
But he remained quiet.
عندما أفرغ سعد كل غضبه.
And then after he had expelled all of his anger.
عرض عليه مصعب ما عنده من الإسلام.
And then مصعب told him about Islam and called him to it.
ولم يجادل.
And he didn't argue with him.
أسلم في نهاية الأمر سعد بن معاذ.
And then سعد بن معاذ accepted Islam.
أيتها الزوجة.
Oh wife.
إنك تستطيعين أن تحول الزوج من حالة الغضب.
You are able to change your husband when he's angry.
وأن تستغلي لحظة الغضب.
And to subdue this anger.
لتصبح أفضل أوقات لك.
In order that it may become the best time for you.
لتملي على الزوج طلباتك.
So that you may ask him for the things that you want.
من خلال تصرفك بامتصاص غضبه.
By sucking up this anger and bearing with it.
وتبريد حرارته.
And cooling his anger.
سيكون لك طائعا مطوعا.
He will say to you in obedience.
قال عز وجل.
Allah عز وجل said.
ادفع بالتي هي أحسن.
Repel with that which is better.
فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة.
For the one that is between you and him enmity.
كأنه ولي حميد.
It is as if he is the best friend or one who is kind to you.
وهذا أمر مجرب ناجح.
And this is something which is known and experienced.
حينئذ يظهر نجاح الزوجة.
And this is when you see the success of the husband.
هذه الزوجة الناجحة في الحياة.
This is the wife who is successful.
يؤتى برجل يوم القيامة.
It will be a man will come on the day of judgment.
فيقول الله تبارك وتعالى له.
And Allah will say to him.
ادخل الجنة برحمتي.
Enter paradise due to my mercy.
فيقول ربي.
He will say, Oh my Lord.
بل بعملي.
But rather with my actions.
أخذ يجادل.
So now he is arguing.
فقال الله عز وجل للملائكة.
So Allah will say to his angels.
اجعلوا عمل عبدي في كفة.
Place his actions in one scale.
ونعمة البصر في كفة.
And the blessing of eyesight in another scale.
فرجحت نعمة البصر.
And then this blessing of eyesight will overcome
it. وثقلت وطاشة أعماله.
And as for his actions, they will be light in the scale.
ولم يستطع أن يوفي نعمة البصر فقط.
And he will not be able to thank Allah for this blessing of eyesight.
ماذا عن باقي النعم؟
So what about the rest of these blessings?
وماذا عن المعاصي؟
And what about his sins?
قال اذهبوا به إلى النار.
So then it will be said, take him to the fire.
قال ربي برحمتك.
And then he will say, no, my Lord, rather with your mercy.
فقال الله عز وجل.
So Allah will say,
أدخلوا عبدي برحمتي.
أدخل
عبدي الجنة برحمتي.
Enter my servant into paradise due to my mercy.
بالجدال كاد يفقد كل النعم.
Due to his arguing, he was about to lose everything.
وكادت أحواله أن تنتكس.
And it was that his situation would have turned upside down.
وقف المتهم مرتكب الجريمة بين يدي الخليفة المنصور.
A person who had committed a sin, committed a crime, stood in front of the خليفة معصوم.
وهذا الخليفة المنصور.
The خليفة منصور.
كان هذا المتهم كان خطيبا مفوها.
And this person who was blamed or accused of something, he was a khatib, a preacher.
وكان ذا لسان جميل.
And he had a way of speaking.
ولكنه في هذه اللحظة.
But in this instance.
أمام المنصور. أمام الخليفة المنصور.
When he was presented in front of the خليفة.
عجز عن الاعتذار.
He was unable to put forth any excuse.
ولم يجادل في هذا الموقف.
And he didn't argue.
بل صمت وسكت.
But rather he was quiet.
قال له الخليفة المنصور.
So the Khalifa said to him.
قال ما هذا الوجوم؟ ما هذا السكوت؟ ما هذا الهدوء؟
What is wrong with you? Why is there so such quiet and silence from you?
وعهدي بك خطيبا ذا لسان.
And I know that you are a preacher who has a way with words.
قال يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, Oh, leader of the believers.
هذا ليس موقف مباهات وجدال.
This is not a place where one argues and debates.
هذا موقف توبة.
But rather, this is a place of repentance.
والتوبة بالاستكانة والخضوع.
And repentance comes with being humble and humiliated.
فرق له المنصور.
So Mansur, he was gentle with him.
وعفى عنه.
And he forgave him.
الصمت يجعل الغاضب
Silence makes the one who is angry.
يتساءل ويراجع نفسه.
Question himself.
فيما فعل وفيما سيفعل.
About that which he did and that which he will do.
ويحاسب نفسه.
And then he holds himself to account.
قال أحد كبار الدعاة.
One of the great callers to Islam said.
وكنت قد حضرت له بعض الدروس.
And I sat with him in some of his دروس.
وهم كبار الدعاة.
And they are from the major people who call to the way of Allah.
قال كنت قنصلا في سفارة بلدي.
He said that I was in the consulate of my embassy.
في الولايات المتحدة.
In America.
وكنت لا أعير الدين اهتماما.
And I paid no attention to the religion.
وفي يوم من الأيام أقمت حفلا.
And one day I had a party.
في مقري.
Where I was.
وكان حفلا ماجنا.
And it was a great party.
وتدار فيه الخمور.
And there was wine and alcohol in it.
والرقص والمجون.
And there was dancing and music.
إذا بمجموعة تطرق الباب.
And then we found that someone was knocking on the door.
وتطلبني.
And someone was asking for me.
فأتى إلي الخادم وقال هناك ناس في الخارج ينتظرونك.
So my servant and butler came to me and he said someone's waiting for you outside.
دعهم يدخلون.
So I said let them enter.
ظننتم الناس الماجمين.
I thought that they were from my friends, the people that were invited.
فقال لا هم يريدونك في الخارج.
He said no, rather they want you to come outside and meet them.
خرجت إليهم ماذا تريدون؟
So I went to them and asked them what do you want.
فإذا مجموعة من الدعاة إلى الله عز وجل.
And then I found that there were a number of people who were calling to Allah.
قال تفضل معنا إلى المسجد.
So they said, come with us to the masjid.
وأخذ يذكروني بالعبادة.
And they were reminding me about worship.
قلت ماذا؟
I said, what?
قال فبصقت في وجه أحدهم.
So I spat in the face of one of them.
وأغلقت الباب.
And I closed the door.
فدخلت.
And then I went.
قال وفي الليل. وفي الليل.
And in the night.
راجعت نفسي.
I thought about this.
صمتوا ما جادلوني.
They didn't say a thing. They remained silent.
وذهبوا.
And they went.
وقالوا غفر الله لك.
And they said, may Allah forgive you.
قال فراجعت نفسي.
So I thought about this.
كيف تصرفت معهم هذا التصرف؟
What did I do to them?
قالوا من الغد.
So the next day.
فإذا بمجموعة تضرب الباب.
A number of people also knocking on the door.
فإذا مجموعة أخرى من الدعاة.
And it was another group of people calling to Allah.
قلت ماذا تريدون؟
So I said to them, what do you want?
قال أحدهم.
One of them said.
أريد أن أخذ أجرا كما أعطيت أخي بالأمس أجرا.
I want to take some reward just like you gave reward yesterday to my brother.
قلت وماذا فعلت بأخيك؟
I said, what did I do to your brother?
قال بصقت في وجهه بصقت أنت في وجهي فأخذ أجرا عند الله عز وجل.
He said that you spat in his face, so he received a reward from Allah.
قلت ماذا أنتم؟
I said, what?
أنتم عاقلون؟
Are you intellectual? Do you have a brain?
قال فشعرت بالإحراج.
So I thought that they were compressing me.
وبعد فترة.
And after some time.
ذهبت إلى المسجد الذي أخبروني عنه.
I went to the mosque that they informed me of.
وتركت قنصلية بلدي.
And I left the consulate of my country.
وتركت العمل مع أولئك.
And I left working there.
وعملت بالدعوة مع هؤلاء.
And then I began to work in دعوة with these people.
الآن أصبحت أنا الآن أذكر الناس بالله عز وجل.
And now I am the one who reminds people about Allah.
أيتها الزوجة لا تنفعلي لحظة غضب الزوج.
Oh wife, do not respond in this instance of anger from your husband.
ستجدين ما يسرك.
And you will find that which pleases you.
إلزم الصمت لا تجادلي.
But rather remain silent and do not argue.
طريقة الثانية.
The second way.
الثناء الصادق كما مر علينا.
To praise someone sincerely and truthfully.
اثني على زوجك ثناء صادقا.
Praise your husband with something which is true.
زوجة واثقة من نفسها.
Whilst being sincere.
ولها مكانة مرموقة في عملها. زوجة كانت واثقة من نفسها.
There was a wife who used to trust or was confident about herself.
ولها مكان مرموقا في عملها لها مكانة.
and she had a powerful position in her job.
وكانت ولها مكانة كذلك بين صديقاتها.
And she had a nice position amongst her people, amongst her friends.
وكانت وقورة عاقلة.
And she was someone who was intelligent.
تقول عن نفسها.
She says about herself.
دخلت البيت يوما.
I went home one day.
وقد تأخرت على الموعد المتفق عليه مع زوجي.
And I was late from the appointed time that I had with my husband.
قالت فصرخ زوجي في وجهي وهو في البيت غاضبا.
So my husband began to scream out of anger.
قال فلانة.
He said, "Oh, you."
قالت فأسرعت إليه.
So I hastened to him.
نحن نقول إنها قالت هلا أبي أو هلا بي كما يقال هلا أبوي يعني هلا بأبي.
One of us would say, "Welcome."
قال فخفت حدته حدة الصوت.
So then he lowered his voice.
قائلا لماذا تأخرتي؟
He said, "Why were you late?"
فذكرت له السبب.
So I told him about the reason.
ثم قلت له.
Then I said to him.
أنا أقل من أن تحرق أعصابك من أجلي.
I am not worthy of you going out of losing your mind over me.
صحتك وراحتك أولى.
But rather your health and your comfort is better than this.
الله يهديك وهداك الله.
May Allah guide you.
إذا أنت تكدرت وأصابك الكدر.
If some harm comes to you.
كل البيت يصيبه الكدر.
Then everything will become harmful in the house.
قال الصوت الآن قال الزوج بصوت هادئ أهدى من السابق.
So the husband said in a lower voice.
قال دعينا من الكلام هذا المبالغ فيه.
He said, do not busy me with this kind of speech.
قلت لا والله يا أبا فلان.
I said, no by Allah, O father of so and so.
الله قائم البيت قائم على الله ثم عليك أنت.
That this house is only standing because of Allah and then because of you.
قالت فسكت وأخفى ابتسامة في وجهه.
And then he didn't say anything, and I could see a smile on his face.
مدح الغاضب والثناء عليه.
Praising the one who is angry.
يقضي على الغضب ويفر الغضب هاربا.
It repels this anger.
بل يحوله إلى رضا.
And rather it changes it to pleasure.
ثار ثائر في الأندلس على الخليفة.
There was a man who was running from the Khalifa in Andalus.
وخليفة وأمير الأندلس هو صقر قريش عبد الرحمن الداخل.
And the Emir of Andalus or the leader of Andalus is from Quraysh.
ويسمى بصقر قريش وهو عبد الرحمن.
And his name is عبد الرحمن.
ظفر بهذا الثائر الذي خرج عليه.
He found him and he captured him.
وأسره.
And he imprisoned him.
وحملوا الثائر على البغل.
And they carried him upon a donkey.
مكبلا مقيدا بالسلاسل.
And he was tied up.
وكان صقر قريش على الفرس. كان الأمير على فرس.
And the leader of the people was on a horse.
فقال صقر قريش لهذا الأسير.
So he said to this imprisoned man.
قال يخاطب البغل. قال يا بغل. يخاطب الدابة. قال يا بغل.
He said to the donkey, talking to the donkey or donkey.
ماذا تحمل عليك من الشقاق والنفاق؟
What you hold upon you from hypocrisy?
يعني به الأسير.
Meaning the imprisoned one.
فقال الثائر مخاطبا الفرس.
So then the imprisoned one said to his horse.
قال أيها الفرس.
Oh horse.
ماذا عليك من العفو والرحمة؟
What is upon you from mercy and gentleness?
قال عبد الرحمن داخل الأمير.
So عبد الرحمن the leader said.
قال والله.
By Allah.
لا تذوق موتا على يدي أبدا.
You will never face death upon my hands.
أطلقوا سراح.
Let him go.
ذكر أبرز المناقب للزوج.
When you mention the best qualities of your husband.
لحظة الغضب.
When he is angry.
تجعله يفيض بمكنونات النفس.
It makes him change his complete personality.
بعد أن كاد الغضب يحول بينك وبينه.
Whereas before his anger was about to separate between you.
وقف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stood one day.
يخطب على المنبر.
And he was giving a khutbah.
بعد صلاة الظهر.
After the prayer of ظهر.
وقد أكثر الصحابة المسألة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the companions were asking him many questions.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مغضبا.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said whilst angry.
قال سلوني.
He said ask me.
سلوني.
سألوني ask me.
فقال إليه قام إليه رجل قال يا رسول الله.
So a man stood and he said, O messenger of Allah.
قال أين مدخلي أين أكون أنا.
He said, where will I be, where will be my destination.
قال أنت في النار.
He said, you are in the fire.
قام آخر.
So another stood.
وكانوا يعيرونه بأبيه أنت لست بابن أبيك.
And they would say to him that you are not the son of your father.
قال يا رسول الله من أبي.
So he said to him, O messenger of Allah, who is my father?
قال أبوك حذافة.
He said that your father is حذافة.
فبرك حينئذ عمر على ركبتي.
So then Umar he fell upon his knees.
وأثنى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he praised the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال رضينا بالله ربا.
He said that we are pleased with Allah as the Lord.
وبالإسلام دينا.
And as Islam as a religion.
وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رسولا.
And with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as a messenger.
سكت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was silent.
وهدأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he calmed down.
وقد ذهب الغضب عنه.
And his anger went away.
بثناء عمر.
Due to the praise of Umar.
ثم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
والذي نفسي بيده.
By the one whose soul is in his hand.
لقد عرضت علي الجنة والنار.
That the paradise and fire have been presented to me.
آنفا في عرض هذا الحائط في عرض الحائط وأنا أصلي.
Right now, whilst I was praying.
فلم أرك اليوم من الخير والشر.
I never saw a day like that in good and in evil.
وهذا حديث رواه البخاري.
And this is in Bukhari.
حاولي أيتها الزوجة أن تفاجئ الزوج.
Try a wife to amaze your husband, to surprise him.
لحظة الغضب.
When he is angry.
بمدحه.
By praising him.
قبل أن تتفوهي بكلمة.
Before you say anything.
فإنك ستجنين تأييدا كاملا من قبل الزوج.
And therefore you will find him that he comes around to your way.
وكما قلت لكم عندما طلبني شيخي.
And as I mentioned to you previously, when my sheikh asked for me,
وقد غضب علي,
and he was angry with me,
أثنيت عليه كثيرا,
I praised him a lot.
فذهب كل ما يجي كل ذهب كل الغضب الذي فيه.
And then all of his anger went away.
بل أيدني في نهاية الأمر.
But rather he supported me at the end.
الاستمرار في الثناء الغاضب.
When you continuously praise one who is angry,
يجعل المغضوب عليه.
It makes the one who is angry with.
يرى استجابة كاملة من الغاضب.
He finds that he will see that the one who is angry will come around to his way.
يحقق له مطالبه.
He will do as he pleases.
المؤمنون يوم القيامة.
The believers on the day of judgment.
ينطلقون إلى آدم.
They will go to Adam.
ليشفع لهم عند الله عز وجل.
So that he may intercede with them.
ليريح الله عز وجل الناس من عناء يوم القيامة.
So that Allah عز وجل may lift this punishment and this difficult situation from them.
وطوله 50,000 سنة.
And its length is 50,000 years.
فيتبرأ آدم قائلا.
So Adam will free himself from this and say.
إن ربي قد غضب اليوم غضبا.
That verily my Lord has become so angry today.
لم يغضب قبله مثله.
He has never become this angry before.
ولن يغضب بعده مثله.
And he will never become this angry again.
ويذكر ذنبه.
And he will mention his sin.
ينطلقون إلى نوح عليه السلام.
So they will go to Nuh عليه السلام.
يجيبهم نفس الإجابة.
And he will say the same thing.
ينطلقون إلى إبراهيم عليه السلام.
And then they will go to Ibrahim.
نفس الإجابة.
And he will say the same thing.
إلى موسى نفس الإجابة.
And to Musa and he will say the same thing.
إلى عيسى نفس الإجابة.
And to Isa and he will say the same thing.
ينطلقون إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So then they will go to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أنا لها أنا لها.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will say I am for it I am for this.
فيسجد تحت العرش.
And then he will prostrate in front of the throne.
ويحمد الله عز وجل.
And he will praise Allah.
ويثني على الله تبارك وتعالى بما هو أهله.
And he will say that which is befitting of Allah.
ويثني على الله عز وجل بكلمات.
And he will praise him with words.
وبمحامد.
And with praiseworthy words.
يعلمه الله عز وجل إياه.
That Allah عز وجل will teach him then.
في لحظة غضب الله تبارك وتعالى وشدة الغضب.
At this moment when Allah will be the most angriest.
ماذا يقول الله عز وجل بعد هذا الثناء؟
And what will Allah say after all this praise?
أمام العالمين.
In front of everyone, all of creation.
قال يا محمد.
He will say, O Muhammad.
ارفع رأسك.
Raise your head.
قل يسمع.
Say and it will be heard.
سل تعطى.
And ask and it will be given.
واشفع تشفع. اشفع تقبل شفاعتك.
And intercede and it will be accepted.
هذه اللحظة التي يتبرأ منها كل الأنبياء.
And this is the moment when all of the prophets will free themselves from this.
لشدة غضب الله تبارك وتعالى.
Due to the great anger of Allah.
يثني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على الله عز وجل.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will praise Allah.
فيستجيب الله عز وجل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And Allah عز وجل will answer him.
أتي برجل عدو للخليفة المنصور.
A man who was an enemy was brought to the Khalifa Mansur.
ووقف بين يدي الخليفة المنصور.
And he stood in front of him.
فقال له.
So he said to him.
يا أمير المؤمنين.
O leader of the believers.
ذنبي.
My sin.
أعظم من نقمتك.
Is greater than your punishment.
وعفوك.
And your forgiveness.
أعظم من ذنبي.
Is greater than my sin.
عفى عنه المنصور.
So he let him go.
وأمر له بعطاء بمال.
And he gave him some money.
أيتها الزوجة.
Oh wife.
بادر الزوج الغاضب.
Hasten to your angry husband.
لكلمات سحرية.
With magical words.
ستقطفين ثمرته.
And you will see its fruit.
بإذن الله تعالى عاجلا أم آجلا.
With the permission of Allah, either sooner or later.
لذلك إخواني مدح الغاضب.
And this is why when you praise one who is angry.
والثناء عليه.
And praising him with what he deserves.
يقضي على الغضب.
This will repel his anger.
الطريقة الثالثة.
The third way.
المسارعة للاستجابة.
Hastening to answer him.
لا تتباطئ أيتها الزوجة لحظة غضب الزوج.
Do not slow down and do not draw away from him when he is angry.
لو أمرك بشيء استجيبي هذه اللحظة.
When he orders you with something at this instant, do it.
بعد ذلك حاولي.
And then after that, try.
تقول امرأة أو تقول إحدى البنات.
One of the women, she said.
صرخ علي أبي في الهاتف.
My father, he screamed at me on the telephone.
قال أين أنت؟
He said, "Where are you?"
أجابت بأدب.
So she said in respect.
قالت يا أبتي أنا في النادي بين يدي الشيخ.
I am. She said, "Oh my father, I am in a park or I am in a hall in front of a sheikh."
لسماع موعظة الشيخ.
So that I may listen to him.
قال الآن الساعة الثامنة تكونين في البيت.
He said, "Right now, this instant, you come home."
يجب أن تكوني في البيت الساعة الثامنة.
At 2 o'clock, you should have been at home.
أجابت يا أبتي.
So she said, "Oh my father."
لم ينتهي البرنامج الشرعي الآن.
This program, this Islamic program, hasn't finished yet.
وقد دفعت قيمة التذكرة.
And I paid for the ticket.
لهذا البرنامج والبرنامج الذي بعده الذي ينتهي في 9:30.
I paid for the ticket for this program and the one after it.
ولا توجد سيارة تردني إلى البيت.
And there's no car that can take me back home.
إلا بعد 9:30.
Except after 9:30.
ومعي مجموعة اصطحبتهن معي.
And I brought a group of people with me.
يا أبتي ماذا أفعل الآن؟
So what do I do now, my father?
قال الآن الساعة الثامنة أراك بالبيت وإياك أن تتأخري لحظة.
He said, "Right now at 2 o'clock, I want you home, and don't you dare be late."
قالت إن شاء الله. يا أبتي.
So she said, "إن شاء الله."
أغلقت الهاتف.
And then she put down the phone.
يقول الأب فكرت في نفسي وراجعت نفسي.
So the father said that I thought about what I said.
وتذكرت كيف تجاوبت ابنتي معي.
And I saw that, and I pondered over how my daughter interacted with me.
وكيف أغلظت عليها.
And how I was oppressive towards her.
فأحزنني ذلك.
So I became saddened.
فاتصلت بزوجتي.
So I rang my wife.
قلت اتصلي بابنتك.
I said, "Ring your daughter."
وقولي لها تتأخر إلى 9:30 لا يضر.
And say that you can stay as long as you want.
لكن عندما اتصلت بزوجتي بعد نصف ساعة تقريبا.
And then, but when I rang my wife after 30 minutes.
فقالت لي زوجتي.
She said.
ابنتك الآن في البيت.
Your daughter is now at home.
قد رجعت.
She has returned.
قال فانكسر قلبي.
So my heart was broken.
أيتها الزوجة.
Oh wife.
أطفئ غضب الزوج بسرعة التجاوب.
Turn out this anger in your husband.
إياك أن تتأخري.
By being quick in answering him and do not be slow in this.
فإنك ستطفئ النار الملتهبة.
For verily you extinguish this flame.
وإلا حرق هذا الغضب الرباط بينك وبين زوجك.
For if this fire comes in between you and your husband.
فكوني كالماء البارد الذي سكب على النار.
Then be like the cool and cold water which extinguishes it.
أتى عمر الخطاب رضي الله عنه عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عمر بن الخطاب came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وبيده نسخة من التوراة.
And in his hand was something from the Torah.
فقال يا رسول الله هذه نسخة من التوراة.
He said, "O Messenger of Allah, this is a copy of the Torah."
وجعل يقرأ فيها.
And then he was reading it.
وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتغير.
And the Prophet's face was changing.
فقال أبو بكر رضي الله عنه.
So Abu Bakr said,
يا عمر.
Oh عمر.
ثكلتك السواكل.
May you be bereaved.
أما ترى ما بوجه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Do you not see what is happening to the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
فنظر عمر إلى وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So he looked at his face.
فرآه غاضبا.
And he saw him angry.
قال أعوذ بالله من غضب الله.
And he said, "I seek refuge in Allah from His anger."
ومن غضب رسوله.
And from the anger of His Prophet.
رضينا بالله ربا.
We are pleased with Islam, with Allah as the Lord.
وبالإسلام دينا.
And Islam as a religion.
ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رسوله.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as a messenger.
وترك التوراة.
And he left the Torah. He dropped it.
فرضي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was happy.
سارع إلى الاستجابة لحظة غضب الزوج.
He hastened to answer him when he was angry.
بترك الأمور التي تغضب الزوج لحظة الغضب.
So likewise do so when your husband is angry.
اعترفي بالخطأ.
And admit your mistakes.
ستجدين التجاوب من قبل الزوج.
And you will find that he responds well to this.
يقول أحد الآباء.
One of the fathers said.
كنت في السابق.
I used to before.
أفضل أحد أولادي على الآخرين.
I used to in the past give preference to one son over the others.
لماذا؟
Why?
يقول لأن الأول.
He said because of the first.
عندما أطلب منه شيئاً.
When I would ask him for something.
أو أنهاه عن شيء.
Or I used to prohibit him from something.
فإنه يسارع في الاستجابة.
Then he would hasten to do this.
بينما الآخر.
Whereas the other.
يتباطأ في الاستجابة.
He would slow and be slow in this.
يقول في يوم ما كنا على الطعام.
So one day we were sitting and eating.
فقلت لأبنائي كلوا من هذا الطعام.
So I said to my sons, eat from here.
وكانوا لا يحبونه.
And they never used to like it.
فقلت كلوا.
So I said, eat it.
يقول فالأول. رحمك الله. فالأول مد وأخذ من الطعام وأكل.
So the first he took something from it and he ate it.
وأما الآخر تباطأ.
As for the other one, then he didn't do
يقول
so.
يقول فحمر وجهي، انتثر الدم في وجهي.
So my face became reddened.
قال فمددت يدي لضرب ابن الثاني.
So then I put out my hand to hit him.
يقول أنا أعلم بأني قد أخطأت.
And I knew that I had made a mistake.
لكن لحظة الغضب.
But because I was angry.
إذا لم يستجب الطرف الآخر.
If the other party does not respond.
قد تحدث أمور.
Certain things may take place.
لا تحمد عقباها.
The results will not be praiseworthy.
أيتها الزوجة.
Oh wife.
إياك أن تتباطئي.
Beware of being slow.
وتحدثه إياك أن تحدثك نفسك بالتباطؤ.
And do not let yourself speak to you, or do not think about being slow.
وعدم الخضوع.
And not submitting yourself.
وعدم الخضوع للزوج.
Submitting yourself to your husband.
فتظنينه ذلا.
And to think that he is not worthy of this.
كوني امرأة جليلة.
But rather be a noble woman.
صاحبة قدر عظيم.
One who possesses a great station.
وصاحبة نظر ثاقب.
And one who sees in the long term.
ومعرفة بعواقب الأمور.
And one who knows the outcomes of the affairs.
ضياع الحياة الزوجية.
Wasting a person's marriage.
بسبب موقف ما.
Due to one instance.
أعظم مفسدة.
It is a greater loss.
من ضياع إمارة.
It is a greater loss than losing a whole dominion.
أو ولاية كولاية الحجاج.
Or a whole kingship like the kingship of Hajjaj.
أصحاب المراكز.
The people who own certain places.
أصحاب المراكز. أصحاب المناصب.
The people who have station and power.
يخضعون لرؤسائهم.
They submit themselves to their women.
حفاظا على المنصب.
So that they may continue upon this.
ويتقبلون غضب الرؤساء.
And they submit themselves to their leaders.
من أجل هذا المنصب.
In order to preserve this station that they have.
فحري بك.
So it is good.
أن تحافظي على أبنائك.
That you should preserve your children.
والحياة الأسرية.
And your family life.
بقلب كبير.
With a great heart and a big heart.
يقول أحد الأزواج.
One of the wives, she said.
من أكبر أسباب المشاجرة بيني وبين زوجتي.
That the greatest reason me and my husband used to dispute.
أنني عندما أنهاها عن شيء.
Is that when I used to say to him, don't do something.
تتباطأ في ذلك.
He would be very slow in it.
مما يسبب الصراخ.
And this would cause me to scream.
والشجار.
And debate.
والهجر عدة أيام.
And leaving him and separating from him for a number of days.
مما جعلني أكره العيش معه.
And then I would hate living with him.
وأتساءل في فراقه.
And I would ask to be separated from
him. من أجل ماذا؟
Over what?
لأنها لم تحسن التعامل معه لحظة الغضب.
Because he was not, she was not able to deal with him when he was angry.
تقول أم المؤمنين رضي الله عنها.
The mother of the believer, she said.
حشوته سادة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. حشوته سادة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيها تماثيل.
I made a pillow for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم which had some pictures in it.
فلما رآها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And when he saw it.
قام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He stood.
وجعل وجهه يتغير.
And his face changed.
فقلت ما لنا يا رسول الله.
So I said, what is wrong, O Messenger of Allah?
أتوب إلى الله ما أذنبت.
I repent to Allah from that which I have committed.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
أما علمت.
Do you not know
أن الملائكة
that the angels
لا تدخل بيتا فيه صورة
that the angels do not enter a house in which there are pictures
وأن من صنع هذه التماثيل
and whosoever makes these pictures
وأن من صنع الصور يعذب
and whosoever makes pictures will be punished
يعذب يوم القيامة
he will be punished on the day of judgment
فيقال أحيوا ما خلقتم
and it will be said to him bring life to those that you have created
أم المؤمنين
so أم المؤمنين
فأخرجتها بسرعة
She said that I took them out quickly. And he did not enter again until I got rid of all of them. Related by Bukhari.
تسابقي أيتها الزوجة للتخلص من المغضبات.
So be quick and hasten to get rid of those affairs which make which cause anger.
وسترين ابتسامة على قلب زوجك.
And rather put a smile in your husband's heart.
يحاول أن يخفيها.
And even if it's indirectly.
إذن أيتها الزوجة.
So therefore, O wife.
مسارعتك في إزالة غضب الزوج.
When you hasten to repel this anger from your husband.
سيمكنك.
It will enable you.
من التربع على عرش قلب الزوج.
It will enable you to become like a queen over the throne of your husband.
وستكونين أحب الناس إليه.
And you will become the most beloved of people to him.
بعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
After the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
القاعدة الرابعة.
The fourth point.
أخبري زوجك. أخبري زوجك
tell you, inform your husband
بأنك تصرفت هذا التصرف
that you have done such and such a thing
الذي أغضبه
which made him angry
من أجله هو
in order to please him
من مصلحته
in order for his benefit
سليمان عليه السلام
سليمان عليه السلام
كان يسير بجيشه لفتح البلدان
he was going with his army to one country
ولدعوتهم إلى الله عز وجل
and in order to call them to Allah
وكان عن يمينه جنود الإنس
And on his right were the army of men.
وعن يساره جنود الجن.
And on the left were an army of jinn.
وفوق رأسه تظله الطيور.
And over them he was overshadowed by birds.
وحشر لسليمان.
And it was gathered for Sulaiman.
جنوده من الجن والإنس.
An army from the jinn and the mankind.
والطير.
And birds.
فهم يوزعون يساقون.
And they were all traveling with him.
تلفت سليمان عليه السلام.
So Sulaiman he turned around.
لم ير الهدهد.
And he did not see the hudhud.
قال ما لي لا أرى الهدهد.
And he said, What is wrong with me that I do not see the hudhud?
أن كان من الغائبين.
Or is it from the absent?
لأعذبنه عذابا شديدا.
Verily I will punish him a severe punishment.
أو لأذبحنه.
Or I will slaughter it.
أو ليأتيني بسلطان مبين يأتيني بحجة لماذا تأخر.
Or else he will come with a clear proof why it was late.
لم يتأخر الهدهد.
So the hudhud came.
وصل بين يدي سليمان.
And he came in front of Sulaiman.
فاعتذر إليه بخبر مفاجئ.
And he excused himself by telling him something else.
ويعتبر من أهم الأخبار لسليمان عليه السلام.
And it was from the most important of affairs.
وكان سليمان يعتني بهذه الأمور عليه السلام.
And Sulaiman عليه السلام was used to give considerate attention to these affairs.
ماذا قال له؟
So what did he say to him?
قال جئتك من سبأ بنبأ يقين.
I came to you from Sabah with a clear proof or clear news.
بنبأ لا تعلمه أنت.
A news that you do not know of.
إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم.
Verily, I found a woman. She owns them and rules them.
وأوتيت من كل شيء.
And she has been given everything.
ولها عرش عظيم.
And she has a great throne.
وجدتها وقومها يسجدون للشمس من دون الله.
I found her and her people. They prostrate to the sun instead of Allah.
من أجل ذلك تأخرت.
And for this reason, I was late.
هدأ سليمان عليه السلام.
So Sulaiman calmed down.
عندما بين له بأنه تصرف لأمر هو يحبه سليمان.
Because he knew that the Hudhud did something which would please him eventually.
إذا كان زوجك غاضبا.
So when your husband is angry.
لتأخرك أو لانشغالك.
Because you were busy or you were late.
بسبب لمصلحته.
And that reason for your lateness or your busyness was due to his benefit.
لا تؤخر السبب.
Then do not be even more late in presenting the reason.
تؤخريه إلى أن يستشيط غضبا.
And do not delay it until he becomes even more angry.
وإنما قبل أن يتفوه بكلمة.
But rather before he says a thing.
قل له السبب كذا وكذا الذي من أجلك أنت.
Tell him of the reason that would benefit him.
لو غضب عليك لماذا أنت تأخرت في الخروج؟ أنا أنتظرك في الخارج.
If he is angry and says, Why are you so late in coming out?
فقولي له.
Say to him.
إني انشغلت بتطيب المكان.
I was busy cleaning.
وبدار الاستقبال.
And in order to receive guests.
لأن ضيوفك سيأتون.
Because your guests will come.
من أجلك أنت.
So it is for your benefit.
لماذا يقول لماذا اليوم طعام عدس؟
And if he says why is today's food bad?
قولي له.
Say to him.
اليوم قد طهيت لأمك هذا الدجاج.
Say that I gave this chicken to your mother.
وأرسلته إلى أمك.
And I sent it to her.
من أجل ذلك اليوم لم أقوم بطهي الدجاج.
So I wasn't able to prepare it properly.
يوم الأيام.
One day.
كسرة. دعا معلما لتعليم ولده ولتربية ابنه.
He called a teacher in order to teach his son.
ليعلمه ويؤدبه.
So that he may teach him.
في أول جلسة.
And in the first sitting.
بين المؤدب وبين هذا الطفل ابن كسرة.
Between the teacher and between the son of Kisr.
عندما انفرد به.
When they were together alone.
ضربه كفا على وجهه. المؤدب المعلم ضرب كفا على ابن كسرة.
The teacher he struck him. He struck the son of Kisra.
اشتكى الابن إلى أبيه.
So the son complained to his father.
لم يلتفت الأب إلى ابنه.
And the father didn't pay any attention.
مرت السنون.
So the many years passed.
قتل الابن أباه.
And the son killed his father.
عندما جلس على كرسي العرش.
So when he sat upon the throne.
قال أتوني بالمعلم.
He said come with my teacher.
جلس بين يديه.
And then he was brought.
قال أنت مقتول.
He said, "You are dead."
أجبت هنا أم هنا.
No matter how you answer.
أخبرني.
Tell me.
لماذا ضربتني في أول جلسة؟
Why did you hit me in the first sitting?
ولم أخطئ.
And I didn't do anything.
بل لم أتكلم بكلمة.
And I didn't even say a single word.
وضربتني على وجهي.
So you hit me.
أنت مقتول الآن.
You are dead.
أيها السياف. قبل أن تقتل قبل أن تقطع رأسه أخبرني أيها الرجل.
And before they chop your head off, tell me why.
سكت هذا المؤدب.
So this man he remained quiet.
ثم قال.
And then he said.
كيف شعورك طيلة السنوات السابقة؟
He said, how did you feel for all these years?
قال
He said,
لو دامت المظلمة على غيرك
were it that this oppression came from other than you
لما وصلت إليك هذه المظلمة
It would not have reached you
لو لم تشعر أنت بالظلم
If you did not feel this oppression
لن تشعر بظلم أولئك الرعية
You will not feel the oppression of the people of your population.
أعلم أنك ستكون في هذا المكان.
Because I knew that you would one day sit on this throne.
أريد أن تشعر بحرقة القلب.
I want you to feel this pain in the heart.
في أثر المظلمة على القلب.
Due to my oppression to you.
لئلا تظلم رعيتك.
So that you do not oppress anyone else.
حتى تشعر بشعورهم.
So that you may realize how they feel.
سكت كسرى.
So he remained quiet. The king.
قال للسياف قال اذهب.
He said to his people, "Leave him alone."
قال تفضل أنت مستشاري الآن.
He said, "Rather sit with me, and you are my advisor."
لو دامت لغيرك ما وصلت إليك.
Were it for someone else, it would not have reached you.
أي لو دامت المظلمة لغيرك لما شعرت بها.
And were the suppression to come from other than you, you would not have felt it.
أظهر حرصه على كسرى.
He found out that he was eager in the well-being of Kisra.
الذي من أجله غضب.
And it was for this reason that he was angry.
ذهب عنه الغضب.
So this anger he went away.
أظهري حرصك على الزوج.
So likewise, O wife, show your eagerness for your husband.
ستكونين مستشارة الزوج.
And you will be his advisor.
كثير من الزيجات أي من عمليات الزواج.
Many of the interactions that take place in the married life.
تنتهي بالطلاق.
Many of them they finish with the divorce.
لأن الزوجة لا تعرف كيف تتعامل مع الزوج.
Because the wife doesn't know how to deal with her husband.
لحظة الغضب.
When he is angry.
ربما مرت علينا قصة عمر رضي الله عنه مع معاوية رضي الله عنه.
And we may have mentioned the story of Umar.
مع معاوية رضي الله عنه.
With معاوية رضي الله عنه.
عندما استقبله بموكب عظيم.
When a great party came to him.
وغضب عمر لماذا هذا الموكب العظيم؟
And عمر became angry at this.
قال وذاك لإظهار عز الإسلام.
He said it is in order to show the great strength of Islam.
فهدى عمر.
So عمر became calm.
ولم ينهى معاوية عن هذا الأمر.
And he didn't say anything to معاوية concerning this.
إذا ما اعترض الزوج على تصرف منك.
So if your husband says something concerning your dealings
وقصدت أنت من وراء هذا التصرف منفعة الزوج
and you, your purpose and your intention behind all of this was to benefit him
عددي له هذه المنافع
so then tell him about this
بأسلوب
in a way
يشعر بأن قلبك عليه
in a way that will cause him to think that you indeed love him and care for him
ولا تتحديه
and do not warn him
لا تقولي له
and do not say to him
أنا ما فعلت هذا إلا من أجلك
I didn't do this except for you.
أتغضب علي؟
Why are you angry with me?
فإنه سيرد عليك بقوة.
Because then he will also become even more angrier.
وإنما عليك أن تبدي له مكانته.
But rather you should make him aware of his station with you.
وأنك فعلت هذا من أجله.
And that you did this for his cause.
وإن أراد أن لا تكرر هذا العمل فلن تعمله بعد اليوم.
And if he doesn't want you to repeat it, then don't do it ever again.
لئلا يشعر بأنه تحدي سافر.
So that he doesn't think that it is just warnings.
فإذا ما غضب عليك يوما ما.
So if he is angry with you one day.
فقال لماذا لم تخاطب النجار؟
And
لماذا لم تخاطب النجار ليأتي لإصلاح هذا الأمر؟
And he says to you, why didn't you call someone to fix such a thing?
لماذا لم تتصل بالحداد؟
Why didn't you call the person to fix such and such?
أجيبه بصدق.
Tell him the truth.
لقد حل عليك الآن القسط الثاني للسيارة ولم تدفع هذا القسط.
Because the second payment of your car is due and you haven't paid it yet.
فأحببت أن أوفر لك المال لتدفع القسط.
So I was saving this money so that you may spend it on your car.
لئلا تؤذيك تلك الشركة.
So that the company does not harm you.
ونحن نتحمل هذه الأمور في البيت من أجلك أنت.
And as for me, I will bear with all of these problems in the house for your sake.
إن فعلت هذا.
If you do this.
انظري إلى الزوج بطرف عينك.
Then look at your husband out of one side of the eye.
ستجده يذهب.
You will find that he will go.
وابتسامة عريضة في وجهه.
And he will have a big smile on his face.
وقد ملأت عينيك.
And you have filled your eyes.
برضا الزوج.
With the pleasure of your husband.
الذي لم يظهر هذا الرضا أمامك.
Who has not filled, who has not shown you this pleasure in front of you.
حرصي لحظة الغضب الزوج.
Rather pay strict attention to his anger.
أنك تصرفت هذا من أجله.
In order to mention to him that you did this for his sake.
إذن هذه نقاط أربعة وقواعد أربعة.
So these are four principles.
من القواعد الثمان.
From the eight principles.
لا تجادل الزوج وإنما عليك بالصمت لحظة الغضب.
The first being do not argue with him when he's angry.
الثناء الصادق لحظة الغضب.
And praising him sincerely and truthfully.
المسارعة للاستجابة للزوج لحظة الغضب.
And hastening to answer him.
اذكري له الأسباب التي من أجلها فعلتي لمصلحته هو.
And mentioning him to him the relevant reasons as to why you did such a thing.
والحمد لله رب العالمين.